to the anti-texture side of things. More of a water-based feel. And then when you touch these, you can tell how soft they are. This is actually all plastisol, it's not water-based. This is plastisol with two screens of water-based discharge. This is using their fashion base, which is a nice soft hand base. And I don't need to deal with water base if I don't want to. On a brown, I can't get white and yellow using that fashion soft, or bright white and yellow. So in that case, I do switch to a discharge. The fashion soft is really nice, really easy to work with. A few textured inks that they're all manufactured by these guys. High densities, HD clears, glitters, metallics. And when I start talking about glitters and metallics, I'm going back to our original concept here, adding bling to your thing. I just got back, I guess it's been a while now, back to Magic in August, which is retail buyers floating and the biggest in the world. And I like to go there at least once a year, sometimes twice a year, to really get a feel for what's popular, what's exciting at the retail level, because that's where usually we're right behind and we're trying to chase that. What's real popular, what's real solid right now is anything that sparkles, anything that glitters and the like. So glitters and metallics are back to the forefront. They're working really solid. And foil techniques we were talking about earlier. Maybe a couple other foil applications. And this is a piece that's got a foil application with some embroidery multimedia on it. If you notice the foils that I'm passing around, they're all in a distressed type of pattern. Working with foils, there's an adhesive, a foil adhesive that's really snazzy, and you can get a fairly decent coverage on your foil. The only problem is covering this solid area of foil and keeping it complete is really difficult. So most of our foils, we purposely either distress or put a pattern in them, so that when we do have any kind of problem with it totally sticking, it doesn't matter, our customer doesn't see that. It also helps in the washability of foil. Foils are tough to get a good wash result. So we like to, a couple of things, we like to distress our pattern so that we get away with a little bit less perfect application. And secondly, if some of it washes off in the laundry, we don't really see the difference. We don't see that it did. Another little trick is we use a similar color underneath our foil adhesive. So if we're going to do a silver foil, I'll print it gray, and then I'll print my adhesive, and then put my silver foil on top of it. Again, if there's some spots that don't quite clear out, I've got a nice a clean edge that at least my customer's going to accept. I'm trying to minimize the damage, how many I'm not going to be able to save. So a lot of what we try to teach about our application for the marketplace is, you can do anything a couple of times. We want to make it run fast and we want to minimize our defects. So a lot of what we try to do is go in and say, yeah, that's a great technique. Now we've got to figure out how to do it quickly and minimize those misprints. Foils come in all kinds of different colors.